You know, one vehicle that has really kind of caught us all off guard and surprised us has been the 124 scale vehicles from Losi, in both the short course truck and the rally car variety. We've got them both here today, and we're going to spend some time behind the wheel of both of them. Hi there, how you doing? We've got both the 124 scale micro rally car and the 124 scale micro short course truck recently released from Losi. They both share a very common platform. They're fun, they're fast, and they're inexpensive to get into and have a blast with this hobby. We have today in one of our offices, we have the prototype basically of the Losi track specifically designed for the 24 scale vehicles. Now this doesn't have all the features of that track. That track you can configure with jump overs and take sections out and things like that, where this is, like I say, the prototype. But we do have some jumps and whatnot set up around this track. And you're going to see in just a few moments exactly what I can do behind the wheel of this micro rally car as Losi's Andy Ziegler gets behind the wheel of the micro short course truck. Yeah, he's going to get the door real hard. Before we do that, we're going to go ahead, pull the body off, and give you a look at the chassis for the 124 scale micro short course truck and the micro rally car. This is the same basic chassis on both vehicles. The main difference are going to be the front and rear body posts, the front and rear bumpers, the bodies, of course, and then the wheels and tires. We've taken the wheels and tires off, and this is actually one of the rally cars here. These chassis feature front and rear plastic-bodied oil-filled shocks, a full-time four-wheel drive shaft drive drive system that lives underneath this shroud here, an all-in-one micro receiver and speed controller, and a 5-wire servo. If you do want to upgrade to a brushless system, which we'll do a tutorial on that down the road, you will have to replace the speed controller, the receiver, and the servo. The car spins on fully shielded ball bearings front and rear, and uses a ring and pinion gear in the front and rear transmissions to deliver the power. To change the battery pack, the battery door is underneath, and that's where the battery lives. It's a real simple, easy, clean, and straightforward way to get the battery pack in and out. This is an important part of the chassis to point out here. This hole allows the servo arm to exit and connect to the bell cranks. This can also allow dirt and debris to enter into the chassis and foul up the drivetrain. Losi doesn't really recommend that you go ahead and run these in dirt because you can foul the ring and pinion gears inside the transmission and the spur gear and pinion gears. Quite honestly, we know that you probably are going to run them in those situations anyways. Keep an eye on that. The gears are inexpensive, and one of the nice things Losi has done is they've packaged the front and rear gearboxes complete with the ring and pinion gears where it's a drop-in installation. Now, in the box with both the 124 scale rally car and the 124 scale micro short course truck, you're going to get a 4-cell, 4.8 volt, 220 milliamp nickel metal hydride battery, a charger that plugs into your wall, two discs, your instruction manual, and a little packet of tools and accessories. And in here you're going to get a 4-way wrench that'll take the wheel nuts on and off. Pretty much that's the only nut that's on this car besides, you know, hey, maybe the loose nuts that drive them from time to time. You've also got this silver wrench here, and this is for adjusting the slipper clutch. There's also spare spur gears and pinion gears in this bag too. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to grab one of our cars that's fully charged up and ready to go, and we're going to lay the smack down on Mr. Ziegler. With both the 124 scale micro rally car and the 24 scale micro short course truck, there's four different paint schemes available for each body style, so you can really get the type of vehicle that you want and desire. There's also clear bodies out there too. Along with the different paint schemes, there's also different wheel and knockoff configurations too. On the micro rally cars, you can either get the red and black and white car, or blue, black, and white car with gold wheels on it, or you can get the white and black or orange and black body with black wheels. On the short course trucks, there's two different wheel options out there, ones that have either a red looking knockoff wheel or one that has a silver looking knockoff wheel. Now please note, these are not functional beadlocks, these are just, you know, for aesthetic reasons here. You know, on this course here, these cars actually, you know, they feel faster than what they might actually be doing. They're probably only doing 12 to 15 miles an hour, if that, but due to the tight circumstances that we have here, they actually feel a lot faster. One of the things I've noticed here, just watching the way that Andy's short course truck and this rally car goes over the jumps, is it seems like the short course truck with its higher bumper can go over some taller jumps without nosing over, where with the rally car, it can tend to dig in a little bit and cause it to flip over. Runtime with the kit battery packs you're looking between about 6 and 10 minutes, depending on your driving conditions, how much you're using full throttle, and things like that. I'll tell you, if you had a chance to take a look at our booth at iHobby 2010, you had a chance to see the actual Losi track. And while this one is fun, that track just blows this one out of the water. We had this neat little jump over section where we had a section removed that if you short jumped it, you'd basically land in the face of the jump and you would have to be marshaled. Speed and performance out of these cars are really good out of the box. And this is the perfect type of scenario to get into RC. They're inexpensive, they're fast, they're fun, they're durable too. We actually used the 24 scale micro rally car and the micro short course truck in our Try Me track at iHobby this year. And out of everything that went on all weekend long, the only issues that we had is we had one car that we stripped a pinion gear on, we had another car that overheated the motor and we had to swap out the motor. These were run for nearly 2 hours straight at some parts during the weekend. And really, that was the only damage that happened all weekend long. A burned up motor and a strip spur gear. That's not too shabby. And that's the great things about these two, is the fact you can go out and just have fun.
Now don't tell him, but while he's out there practicing, we're gonna take our rally car and we're going to install the Acceleron LiPo battery. You'll never see it coming.
You're going down.
Yeah, whatever.
This LiPo battery definitely adds a whole lot of speed and performance to this car. On this tight track here, I'm only able to use about half throttle. Every once in a while I can goose and try to get full throttle, but I really gotta be careful on the throttle. Oh, to the inside of Ziegler? Pass you very much. The 124 scale micro rally car and micro short course trucks from Losi are an absolute blast to drive, and Andy and I had a ton of fun running around the track layout here in the afternoon. I think part of the fun for me was knowing, yeah, I beat him more times than he beat me. But this is perfect in a rec room, in a basement, in a living room, things like that where you just want to go out and have a good time. If you do have any comments or questions about anything that you've seen here today or anything RC related, please feel free to email us at editors@horizonrc.com. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.